Well, thank you very much. I am a little bit concerned about the Europe bashing, I must say. There is the allegation that Europe is applying double standards, discriminating. There was the issue of the proportionality and the civilian casualties in the Gaza conflict. Let me make this point. I think Israel should insist that we discriminate you, that we apply double standards. This is because you are one of us. We are not looking to Israel, and sometimes the response on the part of some Israeli interlocutors is, look what's going on in Syria, look what's going on elsewhere. Those are not the standards that you are being judged by. It's not the standards that Israel would want to be judged by. So I think you have the right to insist that we apply double standards and put you to the same standards as all the rest of the countries in the European context.
But isn't it kind of patronizing to the Palestinians to say that we hold Israel to a higher standard than we hold you?
I'm not sure it is. I think there is a situation where we recognize that there is a very strong very strong party in the conflict and a much weaker party. In that respect, I think engaging our long-standing partner Israel, with whom we have extensive cooperation in trade and cultural affairs, whatever, in a different fashion that we engage others is natural.
So I think that this patronizing attitude towards us, that we should be happy that you have a separate standard for Israel, is really, I'm sorry, it's a statement of contempt for our intelligence. I consider it to be an obsession. I consider Europe's keen interest in the Middle East, specifically Israel, to be an obsession. And it's an obsession that Jews have seen from Europeans from the time of Jesus. And we know what it is. That's one thing. The other thing here is, you know, we have this whole common culture. I mean, really? You know, we respect international law. You guys make it up. There is a binding UN Security Council resolution, Chapter 7 from 2001, 1373, that bars every single UN member nation from funding or otherwise supporting in any way terrorist organizations. And you guys are funneling billions of euros into rebuilding terrorist-controlled Gaza. All right, this is in contravention of binding international law that you signed on to. Now, on the other hand, there's imaginary international law that says that you are required to sanction Jewish projects from Jerusalem and Judea and Samaria. There is no such binding law. You guys are funding settlements in Western Sahara. You're funding them. You're funding them directly. So, you know, this is not a double standard. This is a singular standard for Israel. It's not about international law. It's about an obsessive, compulsive need to constantly pick at the Jewish state. And no, I don't want to be proud that you're looking at us in a different standard from our neighbors, because you're not looking at our neighbors as human beings. What you're saying is they're objects. The only actor in this entire region are the people they're trying to annihilate. And the only people who are supposed to be judged for our actions, and always poorly, are the people who are doing everything possible, more than Europe, right? More than the United States, more than anybody, in order to protect the lives of the Palestinians. So with all due respect, and I would love it if I could have more respect for Europe, but your treatment of Israel, your singular standard, your obsessive compulsive need to constantly pick at the Jewish state, right, makes it very, very difficult. Very, very difficult to worry if you made a helpful statement saying, oh, you know, Gaza should be demilitarized. The only way, and you know this, the only way that Gaza will be demilitarized is if Israel reoccupies Gaza. That's the only way. The only military organization here that is not a terrorist organization and is not a terrorist supporting organization is the IDF. And for that, we are culminated, we are condemned, we are investigated, we are put on trial every single day. Our soldiers are condemned by you. Our soldiers come in and are being called murderers for protecting our families. And I'm sorry, you know, it's very hard for me to feel any respect for this kind of behavior.
I think your point is clear. I'd like to give the European ambassadors a chance to respond to that. Ambassador Varr, Ambassador...